Coming to the calculation part, loss of bulb, loss of mass in the solution bulb will be proportional to W1, that is W1 is equal to proportional to P1. P1 is the vapor pressure of water in the solution compartment. Loss of mass in the solvent bulbs, W2 is proportional to difference in the vapor pressure of pure solvent minus vapor pressure of solution. Because in the solvent bulbs, after the air passes the solvent bulb, what will happen? Whatever it has absorbed in the solution compartment, that will not carry on. It will get subtracted from the solvent compartment, pure solvent compartment. Next, gain in the mass of U-tube is W3 is proportional to P1. How? This is what I explained you. This is loss of water is equal to gain of rot. Loss of vapor is equal to gain of vapor. Means this is the total loss. This is the total loss. I am adding these two things. So if I add these two things, the gain is P01. Now all of you know that relative lowering of vapor pressure is equal to mole fraction of solute. That's equal to WB by WA or W2 by W1. Here it is W2 by W1. See here, we can neglect the W2 in the denominator because the vapor pressure of solute will be always less than that of the solvent. So knowing the values of WA, knowing the values of W1, because it's WA, MB, WB, MA, we don't know this. But we know the values of W2 and W1. So based on this, we can, if you take the ratio of these two, or if you take this one also, we'll be able to find out the relative lowering of vapor pressure. And that is how we are determining the relative lowering of vapor pressure. So now, going to the next one. Yeah, this is what we are trying to explain you, how the relative lowering of vapor pressure can be determined without knowing the masses and molar masses of the solvent and solute. That is called Ostwald.